Okay, hello everyone. Today we're going to look at how to use MindMup, a free mind mapping software. All right, let's get started. All right, here we go. We're going to actually switch over from MindMup Cloud to Google Drive as our storage option so that we can actually save MindMups. As you can see, you can add MindMup 2 to your Google Drive for easier access, and you can basically, anyone can create maps for free, and you can share and collaborate with any other Google Apps document. No registration needed, just use your Google accounts and include Google Apps for work and education. So this allows you to actually save your maps and go back and edit them and also share them with others. So we're going to go and create a new map. Now, it will generally ask you to sign in. I am currently signed in using my CSUMB ID. So here we have a map, and we start off with a central node, so you can press the space bar or double click to edit. Hit double click. Let's start with a main idea. Okay, to change text, select, and then go up to the toolbar. You see larger node font, and just click. Voila, it is now larger. So how to add a child node? So we have the central node selected. Then we go up to the left-hand side of the screen and we insert child node, just click, and there we are. Child node. So we can select here again and then insert another child node. So what if we want to insert an image, because mind mapping is a very visual technique. So what you do is you select, so we're going to select this child node here. We go up to insert child image node. We're going to go off of my desktop, so you'll have to have images already saved on your computer that you're looking to use. I'm picking my Alaska PNG. But that's very, very large, isn't it? So what we're going to do is we're going to resize this image. You see the image is selected, so we're going to go up to the toolbar. We see Adjust Node Image. We're going to make this 100 pixels. All right, let's save. There we go. There's another cool thing that you can do, which is add notes, so that, like, if you want to add different memos to that specific node, if you have more information. So you have to make sure the node is selected, and then you go up to this notepad up here. We could say, okay, Alaska is fun. We want to hide the sidebar, but anytime we want to go and look at that note, we just click on the notepad. So that's, we can also change the background. So we get select this child node here. We go up to this little change node style. We change the background color to blue. We're going to change the text color to lavender. That looks very strange, but we shall go with it. All right then, so that's pretty much the basics of how to create your mind map, Now you can publish it, so you can share it with others. So we're going to go up to publish, and we're going to say, okay, start. And it's going to be published for 6 months. So we're going to call this example. And it's example. So we're going to publish for 6 months. Now we can send links to places. So here's a web here's the web page where it's available. Thumbnail image. You also have an embed code in case you want to put it in a website. So I'm going to take the web page. And here we are. So you can actually share this with other people and just by sending the link. How easy is that? Just copy. And then, yeah. So it's now published, which is pretty cool, I think. All right. I hope that was helpful. Thank you very much. And enjoy making your own mind map.